What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the Riding Dad channel, or welcome if it's your first time. Either way, very glad to have you. We are talking about Christmas gift ideas for the motorcycle enthusiast in your life, specifically the motorcycle rider. Let's roll the intro. We'll come right back here, and I'll tell you what my top picks for Christmas gifts are.
Riding down a YouTube channel, it's the Riding Dad a YouTube channel, it's the Riding Dad a YouTube channel, it's the Riding Dad a thing that you found. Bow!
Alrighty, so we're gonna divide this video up into two different sections. The first section being gifts for people that do not work on bikes whatsoever, just wanna maybe maintain them, just want to ride, that's about it, enjoy riding. This is number one on that list, some new gloves. This is probably gonna be a challenge for somebody if you're not living with the other person, especially if it's a new rider, you don't know what glove size they are. It's gonna be very hard to measure somebody's hand. However, you can always try to do this. I specifically recommend the Odin MFG. Really bright light there, it was hard to tell. These are the heavy hitters, but they have a bunch of different ones. They have perforated, they have non-perforated, they have the OG ones, which are not heavy hitter, just the solid leather gloves. The reason I recommend the Odin's, one, their customer service is very good. Two, their glove fitment and quality is amazing. Pretty much the best glove I have tried. I've tried a lot over the years of riding. And the really nice thing is some gloves will say, touch compatible with phones, thumb and index finger, or pointer rather, and everything like that. And the truth of that is that wears out over time. It doesn't work reliably. The Odin's, might as well just show you, little ASMR. The Odin's have this feature on the pointer and your thumb that you can poke your actual finger off. So this works really, really good for, you know, touching any kind of screens or fiddling with small stuff on your bike here and there, gas station pump, kiosk, whatever it is that you might want to do. This works way better than the touch compatible gloves. And I used to think when I first bought these that maybe over time it would stretch out, or just this kind of separation partition on those two pieces where it actually moves would wear out or get caught on stuff in your gloves. But I gotta tell you, after a couple thousand miles of wearing these bad boys and several hours, a couple hundred hours of riding total, no issues at all with this. The quality is amazing. They're very comfortable to break in, and the heavy hitters get some added protection. So gloves. Gloves are a expendable commodity for motorcyclists. So if you can swing it with the measuring and making sure you can try to get the right one, I will say, what are these? Let me double check. So these are a large, and I actually wear a large slash medium in any other kind of glove too. So I will say Odin, at least the heavy hitter perforated, does run kind of typical sizing. So if your significant other already has a glove, there you go. They have men's, women's, very summertime-y riding and very cold time riding, bunch of different stuff they have. The second thing also is in my pocket, is earplugs. I used to be a naysayer about earplugs until I got the stage 2 on my bike, and between the long highway rides going 70, 75, and then the bike, even with the quiet Arai helmet that I have, it just got to be too much to where it was enjoyable anymore. So for longer rides, I use earplugs. Everybody expertly recommends earplugs for shorter rides as well, but you know what? It's not as fun to worry about that and then the helmet and everything else. So you know what? Long rides, there you go, that's what I do. Eargasm earplugs are specifically the ones that I use. I've tried a couple different ones. I really like these. They come with the very easily taken with you portable, why can't I think of the name, case for them that is waterproof as well. They're very easy to put in and take out. They come with different inserts for whatever you, like whatever decibel cancellation you want, different inserts for it. Just a very, very clean, easy, well done earpiece. They, in my experience, really take out the noise of the wind and the droning of the exhaust, but still allow you to hear your music. If you use music in a helmet, which I do, even better than without earplugs. Just a very, very all around good, well-reviewed earplug. So Eargasm earplugs. The third gift idea I have for the motorcycle rider in your life is a kickstand thing. I don't even know what to technically call these. You can get the black discs at Harley for, I believe they're like $5.95. At least they were before all of this inflation that we've been having. But this was like a two pack for like $6 or $7 on Amazon. All this really does is for any kind of motorcycle, Harley or any kind of motorcycle at all, your kickstand will fit in here. And this is just a puck basically that the kickstand fits over top of. If you are somebody that lives in, I would say snowy, but that's probably not good for motorcycles. A lot of gravel, sandy area, stuff like that. These are really good because it gives a flat surface for the kickstand to sit and slide on when you're actually using it. And it also helps prevent your kickstand, especially sport bikes have the very small nub on the end. Harleys are kind of different, or at least most cruisers are different. They have kind of a bigger footprint of it, but especially sport bikes have a very small nub. And if you get something like this, it's gonna prevent your kickstand from sinking into whatever gravel you have and giving your kickstand a very solid place to lean. So there you go. That is something super cheap and simple. Brings us to the last one, because I have narrowed it down to 4 in each of these categories to keep this video short and not hit on other ones that I would do and other kind of like common gift ideas. The third or the fourth one, and I didn't want to bring the whole air compressor inside the house, so all you have is this piece, is an air compressor. And this actually ties into doing mechanical type work and stuff like that on your bike as well, because an air compressor can be used for many things, brake bleeding, tools, just airing stuff out and, you know, doing that, but specifically tire pressure. Especially if you live in a place that has gas stations kind of few and far between, an air compressor is the easiest way to put air in your tires, both for your motorcycles and any other vehicles you might have. You can blow up a football or a basketball to toss around with the kiddos. And it's just an all-around perfect investment. If I could only buy, you know, 1 to 2 tools, an air compressor would definitely be on that list. Specifically, I have, what is this brand? Astro AI, I believe is the brand. I will link everything in the description. This is from Amazon. This has been it's proven to be an incredibly accurate gauge and actual inflator. It does have the lock piece, so you can just stick it on there and lock it. It doesn't worry, you won't have to worry about it coming off. But I've had a couple of these in the past where the digital readout on here has not only not been accurate, but it's been leaking and everything. This has suffered about a year of garage kept summer weather abuse, and it has worked perfect. It's all metal construction, very good. It has the bleeder attached right here. So this specifically as an attachment for an air compressor, if the significant other doesn't have an air compressor, or sorry, if they have an air compressor, but they don't have an attachment like this, this is a really, really good thing. And you could pick up air compressors in general. You could go as small as a small pancake from like a Harbor Freight or a Northern for about $30 to $50, depending on what you go with. You could also find some at Home Depot for the $50 to $60 range, all the way up on Black Friday sales. I actually got the one I have right now. It's an 8-gallon tank, more than enough for the stuff that I use it for. I've even used it to reattach some of the fencing pieces in my backyard with a pneumatic nail gun. And that was on sale, I think, for like $60 or $70, normally like $150 or $140, something around there. So many, many different air compressors that you can get. Very good. Like I said, if you're even in an apartment or whatever, a small air compressor, a pancake style, is light enough to move up and down stairs, keep somewhere. They're oil-less, so you don't have to worry about having a, you know, a small gas, you know, older style ones are gas. These are all electric. Or even having any oil in there. Keep it in the apartment with no issues, and then fill it up before you go downstairs. Go downstairs or out of your apartment, wherever you happen to be, fill up the bike. A small pancake compressor will be more than enough to top off tires and double check it. I will also say, and I believe I even mentioned this on my last video last year, but for sure, the proper tire pressure is the key to not only a safe ride, but an enjoyable ride. Different tire pressures have different suitability as far as riding conditions and, you know, all that jazz. And it also is a very huge factor in making sure you stay safe on the road and you keep the rubber side down. All right, we got a clean slate. Now it's time to talk about the gifts that I have picked. Top 4, like I said, top 4, just narrowing it down. For the motorcycle lover in your life that does their own maintenance, maybe does their own mechanic work on their bikes and so on and so forth. The first one, which is something I just recently got, I absolutely love. I'm not sure how I stayed without it this long. This socket organizer. So if you're confused about what this is, if you're a non-tool person, it's this blue piece. Blue piece comes with many different sizes for these sockets. These sockets have different sizes of the end caps, so they need to fit on different ones. It's all interchangeable. You can change the sizes with these little picks. Lots of different brands have these just in the Lowe's that I was at. Cobalt and Craftsman had it. Cobalt was on sale. You can get these at about $20 to $30 depending on how much you want to spend. They're all the same, honestly. I spent $15 because mine was on sale, which is why I decided to buy it. Now, if your significant other has a toolbox or, you know, something like that, like the big, you know, crates kind of from like Snap-on or whatever the brands are, obviously this is not something for them because they already have everything organized. But if they have a smaller tool setup, again, maybe you're in like an apartment or a studio kind of thing and you don't have a full dedicated garage, something like this is amazing because it can organize every set of tool sockets that your significant other has. For example, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different sets on here. Granted, a couple of them are small, like I just have a swivel set in different sizes, adapter set, stuff like that, some Torx. But I mean, it's incredible. I have half inch up here. These are 3/8, and I have some quarters down here. These are quarters, I believe, as well, these small Allens. Just an amazing, amazing setup for very cheap. You can get a bunch of decluttering done for your toolbox. This is number one on the list for me. All right, number two on the list is probably something you would have never thought about for a motorcycle, but I guarantee you your significant other probably has if they already don't own it, and that is a butane lighter. Why a butane lighter, you may ask? Well, a lot of times you need to set stuff on fire. You need to warm stuff up. You need to heat things with what they call Loctite, if you're unfamiliar with any of that kind of stuff. Basically this goo that locks nuts and bolts together, essentially. And a lot of times that requires heat to try to get that stuff moving and loosened up. So this is very cheap. You can get a kit, one of these butane bottles. I'm sorry, one of these propane bottles. I don't know why I said butane in the beginning. One of these propane bottles, which is always gonna be blue like this, and then one of these adapters that just basically screws on, is a on-off, and then an actual igniter on it. One of these, for at least in my stores, about $20. The actual propane adapters, also, by the way, I use propane canisters. I use these to set fires on fire, like an actual fire pit fire in my backyard. These are awesome instead of using lighters and matches and stuff. But you can get these actual refill canisters from propane for about $5 or $6, at least where I am right now. To tell you how long these last, I actually have three because they were on sale the other day in my garage. This is the original propane canister that was on this when I bought the kit 2 years ago. Granted, I don't use it a ton, but I've used it to set many fires up in my backyard. I've used it to loosen many nuts and bolts on the bikes and stuff. So definitely get your money's worth with a setup like this. It's very cheap. And also, if you're shopping for a man, not a woman so much for this, but if you're shopping for a man, men love fire. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Men love setting things on fire, playing with fire, torches, so he's gonna love it even if he doesn't necessarily need it that much. All right, we are narrowing it down to the final two topics of this video, the final two products, and an impact wrench. Specifically, I have this DeWalt 20 volt max brushless impact. They might have a small impact wrench, they might have a drill and driver combo. 9 times out of 10, unless they have a lot of tools, they're probably not gonna have a big, beefy impact wrench. What an impact wrench does is basically, this anvil in the front basically oscillates as it turns, and it just really shakes things up, and it gets super, super tight stuff, stuff that you cannot even get with a really long breaker bar, loosened. I love this one. At the time of filming this one, unless I missed one, but I scoured the internet for a lot, this specific DeWalt one, was actually $200 for a 4-amp battery and the tool, when most other competing brands were about $2 to $250 just for the tool alone, and then at least another $100 to $150 for the battery setup with charger. Not only was this the best cost effective at the time, from Home Depot at least, but in addition to that, this actually has the highest foot pounds of breakaway force, which means it's gonna loosen the tightest bolts. Very, very good. I used this for my chain kit install. I actually had a return one that was supposedly pretty good. It was a pneumatic one on my air compressor. I even turned that up 20 PSI over what it was rated for, just to see for the heck of it. Still didn't work. This bad boy shug it loose really, really quick. You could also use these for rotating vehicle tires as well. It's very, very easy for getting the lugs off of those as well. This specific one has 3 speeds and a light. That's speed 3. There's some torque to it. I really, really like this impact wrench. A lot of you, if you watch my videos, probably know exactly what this next one is gonna be as soon as you see it. So many people, out of all the things I use for tools on any of my videos, so many people ask me what this tool is, where I got it, and so on and so forth. I actually just really learned a new piece of information about this tool as well that I'll share with you towards the end of this, but it is this. It is this T-handle. It is a very simple and cheap design. It is very sturdy, made of very good quality. They have this in multiple different sizes. This specifically is the fourth, which means it has a fourth inch socket, male end on this side and male end on this side. And it comes with this adapter to use bits, like your typical bits, hex bits, Allen bits, Torx, anything like that. Screwdriver, flathead Phillips, stuff like that. You put it in there. It has this middle piece that when you hold it, it allows the shaft to rotate freely, has different positions to click, and then if you really need a skinny profile, it comes completely off as well, and you just quick attaches back on. This is really good for hard to reach areas like your starter bolts on Harley specifically. Instead of having to invest in super expensive long Allen sets, you can just have the bits of the Allens that you need, which you probably already have if you're doing a project like that with a starter, and then you can just either take this completely off or put it up at the top, and it's very easy. In addition to the piece over at the bottom, you can smooth or change this adapter to this side, and now you have a ton of leverage to either tighten or loosen with the exact same tool. This is by far my favorite hand tool I have. I just happened to luck out and find it at a pretty good price in Ace Hardware about 2 years ago when I had my Dyna and I started to do stuff. This was an amazing buy. Since then, I've had somebody on almost every other video that I post using it ask me what it is, where they can get it. This specific one is from Craftsman. I don't know of any other company that makes this exact design besides Craftsman. I know my buddy bought a very similar one. It's the exact same design, but it's actually in a 3/8. So I do know they make different size, at least the 3/8 and the 1/4, unless the 3/8 replace the 1/4. But either way, the link for this, if I can find it online, will be in the description of the video, because this is a very, very, very underrated hand tool in my opinion. And it has a million uses, and I love this. I will say, if you have the choice between getting the 1/4 and the 3/8 size, I would say get the 1/4. Most of your hard to reach places are gonna be smaller in size anyway, in which case your 1/4 will come into handy for those socket or bit sizes, a little bit more than the 3/8, and then you can always size up, but it's hard to size down. That is it. We covered all 8 products that I wanted to cover, both if your significant other works on motorcycles and if they just enjoy riding them. There are a plethora of gifts. I could stay here all day long talking about all the things that I use that I would recommend for somebody else to use, but that's not what this video is about. This is a video primarily just to give you some ideas for it. Obviously, the sky's the limit as far as some of the tool stuff I mentioned as far as upgrading those, but this is I believe a pretty foolproof list of some simple. There's obviously some very cheap things on the end of the spectrum and some very expensive things, like that impact wrench, especially if it's not on sale, it's probably about $250, $300 at least for that. But yes, very, very good gift ideas in my opinion. I do appreciate you guys for watching very much. I hope you had a very good Thanksgiving, and I hope you guys have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I will see you guys on the next future videos, I hope, and I appreciate you guys for watching my last videos as well. Thank you guys for watching this video. Please hit the thumbs up. Make sure you are subscribed and you turn on post notifications. Check out all the links in the description and the videos that roll after I'm done jabbing my mouth. Check out my Instagram and my TikTok, and until the next time, guys, ride safe, have fun. Dad out.